Please introduce yourself and what you do.
My name is Jed Carroll. I work as Director of Digital Strategies here at Rudafin in London. I work for a wide range of clients across different sectors.
And so, from a personal perspective, how would you describe your use of social media, or what does it do for you? What's your main objective of using it?
I started off using social media mainly because I had, on a personal level, mainly because I had specific communications problems with clients and the media landscape was changing. The way I use it and the way I've kind of happened to use it is that it's been an outlet for my natural curiosity. So I've used it to find things out, I've used it to augment my memory by bookmarking things and aggregating and curating things. I've met friends through it. So my friend Ian Wood, I actually met when we both blogged on a service called the Always On Network.
Right. So would you how much of that would you describe as digital versus social? Is it all kind of, would you call all those things that you're doing social media, or do you think it's more of a digital platforms? I mean, is that funny use of the word, isn't it?
Well, the platform or the channel's digital.
Yeah.
But what you're essentially doing is social, but what happens in the real world is social.
Yeah.
It's a bit like saying, you know, is rail travel travel, or is it rail?
Yeah.
The rail will get you there, but the activity you're doing is travelling.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so what do you have a particular routine when you're using the tools, or you're trying to sort of get out your messages? I suppose there's two things. You're going to be doing it for clients as well as yourself. But do you wake up in the morning and first thing you do is look at your mobile, or do you have particular times in the day when you look at social media from a learning perspective? How do you describe your routines?
First thing in the morning, I brew myself a coffee, because to be honest, you know, nothing happens. I'm anti-social
you got the coffee, yeah.
Yeah, and then I tend to look at RSS feeds.
Right.
So that aggregates a mixture of social content, but also news content as well. If there's anything really of interest there that I think would be of value to other people, I'll shove it out via Twitter.
So you're scanning, is that for yourself or for clients? This is in Jed mode for clients?
This is in Jed mode as a naturally curious.
Right.
And it kind of overlaps different things. But the great thing about social bookmarking is that if you come across something and it's not in your personal mode, it's in your professional mode, you put a couple of different labels on it. And, you know, you can then pick it up when you're in your professional mode. When I come into work, I've got all these RSS feeds sorted out in folders, so I'll look at ones that relate to my work in my folders, so that will help me create the content.
What, so by industry and topic and things like that?
That kind of thing.
Yeah, and so you've learned over the years how to set that all up yourself?
It's evolved organically.
Yeah, and so for the rest of the company, do you do that for other people or the clients, or how do you pass that on?
I keep an eye on things, and if it's of interest to the company, then I'll pass it on. Hmm. If it just, you know, shows that we're thinking about these things from a corporate point of view, then I'll shove it up on the corporate Twitter feed. I might shove it up on my personal Twitter feed. It might end up being a post on the PR Week blog that I write. It might be, have a linkage to that on the Rudafin Facebook page.
So when you're looking at these RSS feeds, is that at particular times in the day? Do you do a block in the morning and then one in the afternoon, or is it constant, or how are you doing
it? I tend to do it in blocks. The block time will vary because the workload varies
right.
on a day, but I tend to look at it first thing in the morning, and it tends to be the thing that I look at last before I go to bed. So I might have question time on in the background.
Right.
And then I'll be listening to that, but then looking at what's actually happening here. Or I might have a film playing in one window
right.
on my two monitor display at home whilst I'm actually doing this. Because generally you can scroll through the feeds pretty fast and then work out what you want to keep, what you don't want to keep.
Right.
And then really lock into things that you do. And I'll probably read 10% of the content that I actually screen through and bookmark that stuff.
Right. So in terms of your device strategy there, you just describe your device strategy from a mobile perspective and a tablet and a home.
Okay, in terms of mobile devices, I use a Samsung phone with twin SIMs just for voice.
Right.
So that gets SMS and voice. You could consider SMS to be a social one-to-one.
Yeah.
Delivery
but you
mechanism.
Don't. You don't have a smartphone.
I then have a smartphone that I just use for data. I use an iPhone 4S.
Right.
I've got a number of social platforms on there. So I use KakaoTalk. I use Weixin. I use Sana.com's Weibo mobile client.
And this is partly because you're Asian market as well? Or
well, also where a lot of my network is.
Right.
And a lot of these tools are showing a faster degree of innovation because the market structures are different there.
Right.
So you see stuff there that you then see happening in, elsewhere.
Right.
I tend to use Twitter's mobile web client rather than Twitter's mobile client. Just because I preferred the look and feel of it on my smartphone. I have an iPad that I don't really use that much. I tend to use it as a tertiary screen. You can get an application that then allows you to use it as kind of like a touchpad desktop.
It's kind of a non-intrusive thing, isn't it?
Yeah, fits on my Mac. I use two Macs at home. I've got my primary machine's a MacBook Pro. That's about a generation old, but fully spec'd out in memory, and I've got two screens on that.
So how big are the screens? Do you have the
MacBook Pro is a 13-inch screen, so that it's the kind of like compromise between travel,
yeah,
and usability. Yep.
But you plug a bigger screen into it.
And I plug a 22-inch Dell screen into it.
Right.
Because it's cheap, but at the same time, it gives you that kind of scale. And then I have a second laptop that I use for content creation when I'm maybe not in my main den at home, which is an 11-inch MacBook Air, latest model version. That's also handy for things like traveling. It's about the same weight as an iPad, but it's much better for content creation.
Yeah. Okay, so
here at work, I've got a MacBook connected up to a second screen.
And how do you sync all that lot then? I mean...
I used fastladder.com as my RSS reader, and since that's on the web, I don't actually have to worry about syncing.
Right.
Because I'm accessing one client just from different locations. Twitter feed, there's no real synchronization between my Twitter client here and my Twitter client at home.
Right.
But that isn't that big an issue for me. Address books and things like that, iCloud.
Yeah. Okay, and so in terms of content creation, are you trying to blog once a week? Again, you've got a mixture between, I suppose, you're blogging for clients, yeah, as well as yourself, but what do you do about your own publishing?
My own publishing, for PR Week, I try and blog about three times a week. I try and shoot four. For my own blog, I blog twice a day.
Twice a day?
I have posts that go up at 7 a.m. and 7 p.m.
Right. And tell the people watching, what is your blog about?
Well, it's called Renaissance Shambara, and the reason why I called it that was, one, I had an interest in East Asian culture, and that's where the Shambara reference comes in, because it's a type of Japanese film. Seven Samurai, Hidden Fortress, all of them kind of period dramas are of the Champara genre. And the Renaissance was, I wanted to cover a wide range of areas, mainly because a lot of the stuff that we do, you know, digital, marketing, design, it's messy. They don't compartmentalize very easily. So my posts go all over the place, and the common thread is more my thoughts around these things rather than subject areas.
And so how long is a blog normally? Is it sort of a couple of hundred words, or you know,
it varies. I mean, if you think of my posts on a two-day cycle, I'll do one post which I call Links of the Day, which will be an aggregation of different things that I found interesting around the web. A lot of the things I might have collected because other people have written them faster than I would have written about it, and then I'll just make a note on why they're interesting. And then the three other posts will be completely original content. And it could be a few lines around why I think a presentation's interesting, with a slideshare embed or a video embed of some sort. I tend to prefer to embed video from TuDAO. If I can't get the video on TuDAO, then I'll look at Vimeo and YouTube.
So you do a lot of publishing. So how do you advise your clients on that? You know, in terms of, you know, when you're going into a company and because there's going to be very few people that have got, you know, as much energy as you to kind of blog on.
It's more about habit rather than anything else. You don't really need a lot of energy if you're curious and you have a habit.
Yeah.
Then you can publish. You don't need to produce a fully formed 1500 word thought leadership
piece.
Yeah. You know, you can point to something that's interesting. That's fine, because you know you're acting as an editor and an advisor on this is worthy looking at. So it's kind of like demystifying the publishing aspect of things. The reason why I do with regularity is that when you think about Google, there's a number of things that it values. It values relevance, it values freshness, and it values the quality of the content.
Right.
If you start, you know, if you focus around them three things, pretty much everything else can be fixed.
Yeah. So are you going on the basis that if you do five a day, well, at least one will be seen as good, or is it?
I mean the reason why I do two a day is it's getting that balance between what I can deliver that I'm happy to put my name to.
Yeah.
And still keeping up freshness. Also, one effect I do is I syndicate a lot of the stuff out. So I used to use some other disparate tools, but now I use If Then Then That to put the blog posts that I do on my LinkedIn profile, status updates, out via Twitter, as well as going out via RSS. So it's whichever way people want to subscribe to my content.
Yeah, they can do it whatever way.
They can do it whatever way.
And you've automated, or you've made it as easy as possible for you to do all this stuff.
But I've also, you know, I also on them, on at least on some of them channels, I'll put in real-time content that's me putting it in rather than stuff that's syndicated as well.
Right.
Facebook, I'm less bothered about, because I tend not to have people really consuming my status that much.
Yeah.
LinkedIn, I'm less worried about people consuming my status that much. Whereas Twitter, you know, you'll get real-time stuff there as well. It just happens that the stuff I've published, it gets put on there.
So I always ask this question, how do you describe the impact that social media's had in your life professionally and personally? I mean, what does it mean to you?
Okay, impact. I've put on about 7 stone weight. it's from a professional point of view, I've always been naturally curious. I mean, I used to run warehouse parties. I used to work in research in optoelectronics and the petroleum industry. So I had an atypical pre-marketing career. So it's helped probably make me more interested in the area than I would have been for longer than I would have been. It helps pay my bills. My last two jobs have really come about. Possibly last two out of three jobs have come about through my social media profile.
Right.
And the fact that I've articulated things about it. So when I went to Yahoo, I interviewed with one of my internal clients, that guy called Salim, and he was like, yeah, I was reading this really interesting post on folksonomies, which is where you sort categories out by tagging. And he's like, yeah, it was on this blog. And I said, yep, that's my blog. Job interview over. Here when I came to interview, Nick Leonard, our MD, recognised me by the thumbnail portrait picture on my Twitter feed. We'd never met,
yeah,
but he kind of felt that he knew me by following me on Twitter.
Interesting.
So it's had that kind of impact. So it's also meant that it's changed the dynamic of my friends network as well. So I have, and I'd say this really started back with email, which you can consider to be a social media item, in that it's made me have a larger, looser network that, you know, you wouldn't have had previously, because back in the day. Yeah. Phone calls were expensive. That's the reason why Bob Hoskins kept telling dads to spend longer on the phone.
Yeah.
You wrote letters to people, which was a time-consuming process. Mm. So it's meant that I've had a larger, and all of us have got a larger, looser networks.
Yeah.
And I guess that means that we're also more open to opportunities.
And so finally, what is your top tip for people going social? People that are looking at this, not blogging, not tweeting, what's the tip you'd give people, or a couple of tips?
I think first of all, be pragmatic. You know, some of these social platforms won't suit you. I do a lot less on Facebook than a lot of people.
Mm.
It doesn't suit me. I don't particularly like the user experience. So I'm on there so that I can use it professionally to manage client pages, to set up client pages, to set up applications, things like that. I have a Facebook page there for my blog if people really want to follow it on Facebook. Mm. But my own personal profile, I do a minimal amount of stuff there.
Yeah.
Work out what's going to work for you. Think about how it can help you. Be smarter. I mean, the thing that really lit things up for me was the fact that I could use blogs and social bookmarking tools. I really like pinboard.in to basically augment my memory.
Mm.
So, and to help with my thinking. So when I'd be writing about a blog, part of that process you're seeing when I'm writing it is actually me trying to work out, how do I actually feel about this thing?
Mm.
And then I'll come to a conclusion through that writing process. That sounds a bit like therapy, but yeah, I guess that it probably is. And social bookmarks, I found this great thing about 4 months ago. And normally you might forget it, or you might have lost the piece of paper that you had it written on.
Yeah.
You know, it's a search away.
Yeah. Brilliant. Jed, thank you very much.
Thank you, Bob.